गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ग्राफिकल मेथड ऑफ थर्ड इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन। ग्राफिकल मेथड ऑफ थर्ड इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन मींस पोजीशन वेलोसिटी रिलेशन। व्हाट इज पोजीशन वेलोसिटी रिलेशन? एंड व्हेन यू स्टार्ट टू डिराइव पोजीशन वेलोसिटी रिलेशन इक्वेशन बाय ग्राफिकल मेथड, फर्स्ट व्हाट यू डू, सेम स्टेटमेंट यू राइट, let a body is in uniform acceleration, their initial velocity is u, final velocity is v, time taken by body is t, distance covered by body is s, and acceleration produced due to the change of velocity is a, right? Now okay, then what you do for third equation of motion, same as the second equation of motion, what we write? Distance covered by body, and there I told you that distance covered by body means area of trapezium. And in second equation, what you did? Area of trapezium you divided in two parts, area of triangle, area of rectangle. Here we will not divide area of trapezium in two parts, only we write area of trapezium, right? Now, and area of trapezium, all of you know, half into sum of parallel side into height, right? Now let us see, first what you write? We write distance covered by body S is equal to area of trapezium, which trapezium? O, right? Now O, here A was there, O A B C, area of trapezium O A B C. And area of trapezium already you know, 1 upon 2 sum of parallel sides into distance between two parallel lines. Which lines are parallel? CB and OA are parallel, and distance between them is what? AD. Distance between them means altitude. Altitude means height. Height means perpendicular length, means into AD. Right? Now 1 upon 2 sum of parallel side means what? OA plus BC, height is AD. AD means, okay, you write AD, height is AD. Now 1 upon 2 OA means initial velocity, U final velocity, into AD means AD. AD means OC. Why? You see ADCO is a rectangle, and in rectangle already you know that opposite sides are equal and parallel to each other. That's why value of AD is equal to value of OC, and we will write here T. Right? Now I hope that all of you understand. Here what you do, in third equation of motion you see T is not there, then what we do? We eliminate T by using first equation of motion. Now see, what is first equation of motion? First equation of motion is, here we write, using first equation of motion. And first equation of motion is what? V is equal to U plus AT. Can I write this one? V minus U is equal to AT. Or can I write it? T is equal to V minus U upon A. And this value of T, what you do? You write here in place of T. And when you write in place of T, what will come? S is equal to 1 upon 2 V plus U. Beta, U plus V or V plus U both are same. In place of T, what you write? V minus U upon A. Now see, use formula A plus B, A minus B. Algebraic expression, A plus B, A minus B, what will be there? A square minus B square. That's why we can write 1 upon 2 V square minus U square, and 2 into A, 2A. Means, sorry, you write only A. By cross multiplication, 2 and A, you send left hand side, then what will come? 2AS. And 2AS means what? V square minus U square. Can I send U square left hand side? Then what will come? 2AS plus U square is equal to V square, Are you writing proper way? V square is equal to u square plus 2as. This is the third equation of motion. This is the relation between position and velocity. I hope that all of you understood, right? First equation of motion. All of you see here, v is equal to u plus at means here only velocity, time and acceleration is there. Acceleration is also related to velocity. When velocity will be there, then acceleration will be there, right? Now, then what to write? Suppose that body is moving with uniform velocity u, right? Now, and that time body position is at A. Body position is at A. After t seconds, what happens? It velocity becomes v, and distance covered by position of body is at B. Position of body is B. Then acceleration will be, this slope AB is acceleration. Why? Position of body was A and now it is at B. Initial velocity at point A, u was there and now it is v. Then this AB, this slope is acceleration. This slope is acceleration and all of you know it. Acceleration is equal to change of velocity. Acceleration is equal to rate of change of velocity. Means initial derivative. All of you write it. Acceleration of body. Acceleration of body is equal to rate of change of velocity. Rate of change of velocity. Rate of change of velocity. And rate of change of velocity means what? Rate of change of velocity or speed, both are same here. Otherwise, one is vector quantity, another is scalar quantity. Okay, is equal to slope AB. Slope AB is equal to slope AB. And slope AB means what? At B, velocity is V, and at A, velocity is U. Then, what will be there? Slope AB is equal to, now change of velocity, change of velocity final is v, initial u. The change of velocity what? Previous velocity oa was there, that is u. Now at this time cb, and this cb is equal to, suppose that ce is there, it is equal to oe. Then what to write? Oe minus oe, or if you want to write ob minus this, you see that OA and CD both are parallel, then OB minus CD upon time. Here time 0 was there, and when you reached, when body reached at point B, time taken by body is T, that is OC, that is OC. Now all of you see OB is not there, O here CB is there, CB. But you see CB and OE both are parallel and equal. Then can I write in place of CB OE? Then here you write OE. CD and OA both are parallel and equal. It is rectangle. And this is, you see, OCBE is rectangle. OCDA is also rectangle. And all of you know, in rectangle, opposite sides are equal and parallel. Then OE, and in place of CD, can I write OA? That is OA. OC means time T. Okay, OC means OC, right? Now here, what you told it? Acceleration denoted by A. Acceleration denoted by A. OE is what? OE is final velocity. That is V. OA is what? Initial velocity. That is U. And OC is what? T. Means A is equal to V minus U upon T. Now, cross multiplication. When you make cross multiplication, what will come? A into T is equal to V minus U. Can I write? Or can I transfer minus U left hand side? Can I transfer? Now see, when we transfer, what will come? U plus AT is equal to V. And when you write it in proper way, then what you will get? V is equal to U plus AT. This is first equation of motion, or this is relation between velocity and time. Right now?
This is relation between velocity and time. In this way, we derive first equation of motion. Okay, motion. Second equation of motion means what? Position-time relation. Relation between position and time, that is s is equal to ut plus half t square. In second equation of motion, what we do? We write distance is equal to. And class, you keep in your mind, in graphical method, anywhere in science, in equation of motion, anywhere you write distance, then that distance means area. It means, suppose that question is the distance covered by body, then you know that what to write? Area, which area? This area, area of trapezium, which trapezium there? OABC. You see, OABC, if you draw a rough diagram, then beta, this diagram is there, no? Class, you see, this diagram is there. Here O is there, here A is there, here B is there, and here C. What is there? Trapezium. Why trapezium? Opposite sides are parallel and two sides are non-parallel is there. Now, in which way solve? And beta, in second equation of motion, and you see, in second equation of motion, what you do? Trapezium you divide in two parts. First, this part is triangle is there, and this part is rectangle is there. Then, in second equation of motion, when you find distance, you write distance covered by body is equal to area of trapezium OABC, and this trapezium you divide in two part. You divide in two part. First part is triangle, second part is rectangle. Triangle area already you know, half into base into height, and area of rectangle length into breadth. Now statement will be same. Statement will be same. Let a body moving with uniform velocity u, and you know, you keep in your mind, body is always in uniform acceleration. Final velocity is v. Time taken by body t. Distance covered by body is s. Now here, what to write? Distance traveled by body, a distance covered by body s is equal to area of trapezium OABC is equal to area of triangle ABD plus area of rectangle OADC. Area of rectangle, which rectangle? Area of rectangle OADC. Now, area of triangle ABC, half into base into height plus area of rectangle length into breadth. Area of half, base is AD, AD into height is BD, height is BD, plus area of rectangle length into breadth, length is OC, and height breadth is OA. OC into OA. According to graph, 1 upon 2. Beta, OC and AD both are parallel. Means OC and both, it is rectangle. In rectangle, opposite sides are equal. That's why value of OC and AD both are equal. Then can write here T plus. What is BD? BD. Beta, you see, BC is C to B. C to B means OE is V and CD is U. Then BD is V minus U. Beta, this length when you will get? When in total you subtract this CD. Means, can I write into V minus U? Plus OC. OC means T. And what is OA? OA is U. And just you remember, first equation of motion. First equation of motion is what? First equation of motion is v is equal to, first equation of motion is v is equal to u plus at. Right now, or can I write at is equal to v minus u? Can I write u transfer u left hand side? Then what will come? V minus u is equal to at. Means, can I write in place of v minus u at? Can I write? Then what will come? 1 upon 2 into t into at plus tu. Tu means you write in proper way. T into u means you write in proper ut. And s is equal to 1 upon 2 into t into at plus ut. Beta t into t, what will come? T square. Then can I write it in this way? Half at square plus ut. Or you write in proper way. Then when you write in proper way, what will come? S is equal to ut plus half at square. This is second equation of motion given by Newton. And this equation is called relation between position time. Relation between position and time. Right now? Okay. These two equations, you try to solve it. And today no homework is there. Only one homework is there. Derive first equation of motion and second equation of motion by graphical method. Right now, their notes I will give you. If you have not booked, then notes I will give you. Right now, art book scan I will give. Right now, okay. We derived first equation of motion, velocity time relation, second equation of motion, position, velocity relation, and the third was position. No, second was position time, third is position and velocity or position and speed relation. Right now, I hope that all of you understood it. And again I am giving you derivation of second equation of motion and first equation of motion by graphical method. Right now, which one you try to derive it? Why? Because in examination one will come. Means there are two methods, mathematical method and second is graphical method. In mathematical method or graphical method, one will come or any two will come, that derive this equation, derive that equation by this method or by that method. Okay, thank you.